Ukraine. This is a huge honor to me and privilege. I feel like I say that all the time, but I'm sincere. These are privileges and honors. Our next honoree is the LebMASH, the Lebanese Medical Association for Sexual Health. I'm going to let them do a lot of the talking and about their journey and their accomplishments in Lebanon, a country where LGBT people are regularly persecuted and prosecuted for whom they love. But the list of their accomplishments includes things like pushing Lebanon's psychological and psychiatric professional associations to renounce gay conversion therapy. They also, it's important to know that in Lebanon, the law that outlaws homosexual behavior reads something like that sexual intercourse that is an act against nature is punishable by law. And what LebMASH did is they got the psychiatric and psychological professional associations to put out declarations that homosexuality is not a disease. And then, as a result, a direct result of that, that law became more difficult to enforce on gay people, and there have already been 4 court cases that have been overturned because the psychiatrists and the psychologists say it's not a disease and therefore it's not against nature. They've also developed an LGBT health curriculum, and they've done all of this. And one more thing, they work with the Ministry of Health to help the ministry understand the importance of LGBT competency in addressing issues of substance abuse. And they've done all this in their first 6 years with a volunteer board of 9 people. So that's amazing. And what makes LebMASH particularly dear to GLMA is the role that GLMA played in its formation, because the idea for LebMASH was really inspired by GLMA. I mean, LebMASH was initially formed at a GLMA conference just a few years ago. So their work, to me, is inspiring, courageous, life-changing, and life-saving for countless number of LGBT people in Lebanon. So please welcome to the stage Bianca Saloum, the executive director of LebMASH, and Omar Harfouch, the president of LebMASH.
Some doctors in Lebanon refer to Mike Pence when they encourage their pray the gay away strategy. face barriers to access of care from the minute they step out of their homes until they leave their provider's office. However, just like the struggle is the same, the resilience of the LGBT community at large and within healthcare providers in particular is also quite similar. We are proud to say that we at LebMASH were able to be the voice that shouts back against the proponents of conversion therapy. We were able to bring guidelines around transgender health closer to providers who lack knowledge about this topic at large. We were able to reassure many LGBT patients that they have the power to hold their providers accountable and report discrimination and any breach of confidentiality that they face in healthcare. Of course, all this wonderful work would not be possible without the persistence of our board members, who have dedicated their time and efforts to support the organization. Our staff, especially Bianca, our executive director, who really works day and night, and I tell you, a 7-hour difference between the East Coast and Beirut does not help in order to make sure that the organization is running perfectly. Our volunteers who are motivated to learn and to teach others about LGBT affirmation. And of course, the biggest thank you goes to our donors who have believed in our cause and who they too wanted to say no to health discrimination. Let me make a quick pitch here that you too can become a donor. If you visit our website at lebmash.org. You see, GLMA taught us very well to every opportunity when it presented itself. Thank you so much, GLMA, for this honor. But most importantly, thank you for being a guiding hand throughout this journey. We promise you that this award will only push us further in achieving LGBT health equity.